I'm here, y'all. Alright? Taking a little bit of time. This is my first time doing this, so y'all gotta roll with me, okay? I got little Frankie Beverly and Maze in the background, because what we're gonna talk about tonight has got everything to do with something like
joy and pain, like sunshine and rain, yeah.
I know what I'm talking about out there. Alright, so here we go. Y'all listen to that. Let me finish doing what I'm doing, okay? Come on. I'm trying to finish what I'm doing, but I'm excited. Because we're gonna slap the devil in his face tonight, alright? We're also gonna grab hold like a vice grip on that fear that we may have today, okay? So, y'all work with me because I'm putting all this together by myself, so. Got a lot of stuff for you today. When God tells you, hey, y'all, I need you to go online and welcome the people to the homely hookup at 6 p.m., you got to do that, right? So I'm a few minutes off to 6 p.m., but I'm real close. So y'all hold tight because we're going to get it in, all right? Whatever you got to do, get it together because we're going in, no doubt. All right? Thanks, God. I love you. We're going to wait for a couple more people, a few more people to get on here. And then we're going to pump it up for God. We're going to pump it up for Christ. We're going to pump it up for life. You feel me? In this house, you feel me? Literally in my house too. Your friends, we got some more people coming online. I'm on my tablet trying to work out a couple of things right here, and once I do that, I'm telling you, God's got some stuff for you today. I want to give you one scripture to think about before we get into our subject that we're going to talk about in reference to the two meanings of fear. Oh, we're going to get into that. But I want you to take this scripture right now and put it in your head. And it doesn't matter what faith that you come from, you should be able to relate and feel this. You know, whatever, with the God of your understanding, I want you to receive this. Is that okay? Yes, yes. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Not by power, nor by might, but by God's Spirit, thus saith the Lord. Okay? Not by power, nor by might, but by God's Spirit, thus saith the Lord. All right? I see you. Maurice, I see you. I see you. Oh, my goodness. All right. Come on in, guys. Come on in, because it's going to be good. It's going to definitely be good. If I can get this technology to work with me and go to the frame that I needed to go to, I'm going to go ahead and move further into what God has asked me and called me to do. So stand by. Let me get my other playlist here so that I don't have to look down anymore for this music. Because it's music, and I'm going to use it as I always have to be a part of what God is going to do for us tonight. And I am working this out. Stand by, be patient, okay? But that scripture, again, not by power nor by might, that comes from, in the Bible, the book of Zechariah 4:6. So hold on to that. Because I'm working on this tablet and it is not working with me right now, but I think I just figured out how I can move this along. Okay, looking good. Zechariah 4:6, not by power nor by might, but by my Spirit, thus saith the Lord. That's what we need right now. We need to understand that God is asking us to take this time to be with our family, our friends, but to also take this time and be with the Lord. Seek, go inside of ourselves and look for our better and our greater selves, because it's there. You feel me? I just want to encourage you today, all right? And there's so much I want to give you, and I'm not sure I'm going to be able to get to it all, but let me do this. Bible, let me just say this. B-I-B-L-E. And I want to do this ecumenically, okay? This is what the Bible means to me. And I wish my friend Josie, who's in Atlanta, was on tonight. Oh, Angela, hey, how are you? Mimi, what's going on? I tell you, so good to have you. Bible, B to me means to believe. No matter what faith background you come from or what you want to be or do in life, you've got to believe in something. You feel me? And if you're going to have a strong foundation, you've got to believe in something. Does that make sense? And the Bible, for me, just for me personally, I want y'all to understand, because I don't believe that my belief system, that everybody has to believe exactly what I believe or believe that Jesus is the only way. I'm not that kind of Christian, okay? So I want you to hear me out and be patient. And let me get back to that B in Bible. Believe. That's the first thing we got to do. Whatever the God is of our understanding, we've got to believe in it. Amen? All right? I is to inspire. That's what the Bible did for my life. That's what God did for me. Inspired me. And then B, I was blessed, so I have a responsibility to be a blessing. All right? I was blessed, so I have a responsibility to be a blessing. And then L is all about love, baby, whether anybody else want to believe it or not. But I'm not talking about that ooh-ah love. I'm talking about that agape love. I'm talking about that love that is unconditional. I'm talking about that love. Thank you so much, Kendall. Thank you. Love you. I'm talking about that love that, it, you know, I remember a situation with someone and their loved one was in a wheelchair and they had lost all of the ability to move their body, but their spouse stayed with them anyway. You know, that's when I link up with whoever that is that God wants me to be with, that's the kind of love I want to give them, and that's the kind of love I want them to give me. Even if I can't do what I used to do, will you still love me and give me the option to say to you, this is my prison, not yours. If you need to step off and continue to win, to live your life. Bible, believe, inspire, bless, love. And that E, just for me, means empower. I have been empowered. I am 57 years old. I'll be 58 years old this year. And I don't know if the coronavirus has set its sights on me. But if it has, this is what I want to do, and this is how I want to go. Empowering you to have faith, to have hope, to love yourself, to love somebody else, and to never, ever give up. That's what I want to do. Hey, Reverend Robert, God bless you. Thank you for checking in tonight. It's all about God gave me a balm of Gilead. I said, God, what can I do in this hour? God said, I've never asked you to do nothing that you can't do. And I've never asked you to use anything that you don't have. Use what you have and do what I taught you to do and gave you the ability and the power and the will and the strength to do. Just open your mouth and I will do the rest. So I want you to know this is my first Facebook Live. I've never FaceTimed anybody. I said, you know, I stayed away from it. But I want you to know today that God said to me, do you understand you've been in ministry over 33 years? You can never go and visit everybody's life that you have touched. You can never even get to your family members as quick as if you flick the switch on Facebook Live. I said, oh my God, what have I been missing? I miss y'all, all of you who know me. I miss y'all. Hey, Skylar. Hey, Yvonne. I miss y'all. I love you. Hey, Allison, when I tell you I love you, I mean it. And that isn't because of anything that you've ever done for me. That's just because I love you, because God first loved me. That's what I'm rolling with. Hey, look at my buddy, one of the best female drummers on the planet. Kiara, how are you? Oh my God. What a blessing, what a blessing. And that's all I've been wanting to do is get to you. That's all. I miss you too, Skylar. What's up? Aurette is in the building. My God, the most talented chef in Oneonta, New York. I'm telling you, you got to check out the food at Aurette's. You feel me? But listen, we can do this together. We're all in this together, right? So I'm going to tell you what, like I said, this is my first time doing this, so everything is not going to be spot on or whatever, but spiritually it's going to be right on point. Hey, Rebecca, how are you? Hey, Lisa Thompson, how are you? All right, Plainfield in the building. I'm so glad that you guys are joining me, and I promise you that God and I are not going to disappoint you. My brother in the ministry of First Presbyterian Church, Cooperstown, Brother Thomas Rhodes, how are you and the family? I love you. Oh my God. We're going to get it in. You know, this is how God is asking me to bring people together in a moment such as this, where we don't have nothing else to do but be still. And you know, when this went down, that's what God said to me. It's all about be still and know that I am God, that the Creator is God. We need to be still. God needed to shut us down. Greed was overtaking the land. God needed to shut it down. Money was just overtaking our young people, not being protected and taken care of and led in the right way. Too many of them, not all of them, but too many of them. God said, I had to shut it down. Oh my God, thank you, Jesus. God brought to me when Moses had to speak to Pharaoh and say, let my people go. But Pharaoh was hard-headed. Pharaoh didn't want to hear what Moses had to say. But Moses was chosen, called, ordained, and appointed to do what he was doing. So what I'm going to tell you right now is I'm not turning on Facebook so I can see how many of you will check in. I'm turning on Facebook so I can see how many souls that God can get in. You feel me? I don't care about money. I don't care about what I look like right now. The only thing I care about is being an instrument and a vessel that God can use to love on you. DJ Kelly, Big DJ Al, what's up, my friend? Oh my God, Church in the Hood, South Carolina has just checked in. That's what's up. I'm telling you, I'm feeling y'all, and I had no idea this is how I could get to you, because God keeps giving me all of this wonderful, wonderful manna from heaven, and I'm not like I want to keep it to myself, but God, I don't have the money. I don't have the ability to travel, you know, like Kanye West. I don't have all of that to hire all these people to do all these things, but God told me today, all I need you to do is one thing. Let my people know that I love them. Let them know that I will never forsake them. All I need them to do is turn from their wicked ways. All I need them to do is acknowledge that I created breath, that I created water, that I created the sunshine, that I created the gay person, the straight person, the black person, the white person, the Asian person, the Indian person, the Latino person. I need you to let them know I created
sexual orientation. I created your intellectual ability. I gave you all of that. How can you leave me out of the equation? I'm not going to be God X. Jesus. Thank you, God. God says, I've not asked you for nothing but to acknowledge me. And I've given you everything that I can possibly bestow on you. God says, but I need you to get better. We got kids dying for nothing. We got children mistreated, unfairly disrespected and abused. We have elderly people who are not being properly cared for. It's our duty to do that, elders. If you are an elder, if you are an adult, it's our responsibility. It's our responsibility to take care of the young people. It's our responsibility to point them in the right direction. It's our responsibility to make this world a better place. It's our responsibility, all of us together collectively, to leave this world better than we found it. It's our responsibility. So in this time, as we sit and we reflect on what we're going through right now, I want to send up a prayer for every lost life that has taken place to this coronavirus. Lord God, I want to pray for their families. I want to ask God that you give them strength to get through this and let them know that their loved ones will want them to continue and to go on and fight the good fight. Lord, I want to pray for the health workers that are on the front line. I want to pray for the officers that are on the front lines. I want to pray for the military that have been put in place to be on the front lines. God, we need you right now to step in. We don't want to be on lockdown for a long period of time, but we know we got to get some things right in our minds, our hearts, and our spirits so that you can lift this latter-day plague that has been allowed to come through our land and bring a death angel with it. We know, God, that you can change things in an instance, God. And we need you to help us see what you need us to see. Oh, my God, thank you. We are going to be still and know that you are God and that we can't X you out of everything. We can't X you off television. I remember when I was younger, I would see God somehow in ministry, through a minister. I remember, and I want to give a shout out to Bishop Carlton Pearson. I remember seeing him years ago. And we don't see that anymore. We don't see the representatives of Christ like we used to. Aside from the mega churches who can afford to pay to be on the air. And that's a good thing. But guys, it really boils down to what's going on the ground. If you're a pastor that I can't get to, that I can't speak to one-on-one, I understand you are my pastor corporately and that you are praying for me. But there are a whole bunch of pastors that are on the ground that we need to meet and we need to connect with. The ones that we can get to, we need to get to them and they need to get to us. So I'm one of those pastors. And I want you to know, Church in the Hood's faith and hip hop movement is here for you. You just reach out and whatever I can do to lift your spirits and to remind you that you are special, that you are stronger and more powerful than you know, I am here. And there is nothing that is going to upset my spirit enough for me to turn away from God or turn away from you. I'm Reverend LaDonna Clark, AKA Lady Jam, and I want you to know This is the beginning of Lady Jam 2020, baby. You feel me? Let me tell you what the Jam stands for. The Jam stands for Jesus Anointed Me. Jesus Anointed Me. Lady Jam 2020, that's what it's all about. For me to turn up my game for God, for Christ Jesus, and let the whole world know that we are greater together than we are divided. You feel me? And right now, I just want to, because God always be flipping the script, you know? I'm going to turn on some music that God has given me, and I'm going to just let God get busy, and I'm going to pull up that word for you today, the actual word, okay? Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Elise, Alice, hey, Alice, Bernadette, what's up? Hey, oh my God, I'm sorry, you know, this is coming up on the screen. I got to get used to checking the screen while God is, the Holy Spirit is moving. But let me just begin, oh my God, because I feel excited right now. Woo, so, you know, Lady Jam also stands for the fact that it's about the music ministry in me. So let's go into a little bit of that music ministry right now. Is that all right? Somebody give me a wave right now. Is that all right? And as Marsha Hugs just shared with me, I'm sending you air hugs. Air hugs for everybody. Woo! Let me tell you how I feel right now. I'm going to pump this up a little bit. Is that okay? Here we go. Woo! All right. Hang out with me. Hang out with me. Because it's Sunday. Oh, and I feel all right. I said it's Sunday. Woo! And I'm going to turn up in Christ. I said it's Sunday. Woo! And I feel all right. I said it's Sunday. Excuse me. But I'm going to turn up in Christ. Woo! I'm going to turn up. I'm going to turn up in Christ. I'm going to turn up. I'm going to turn up, turn up, turn up in Christ. Is that all right? Woo! I'm telling you. Thank you, Jesus. Love me. Love you. That's what God does each and every day. Come on. Woo! AD's in the building. Come on. I said, there ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party. Yeah. I said, there ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party. Woo! I said, ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party. I hope we're still there, because I'm getting something on my phone that's making me wonder. Somebody say you're still there. Come on. Woo! Wait a minute. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. One more time. It's Sunday. Come on, somebody wave at me and let me know you're still there. It's Sunday. Come on, somebody wave. I need you to wave. It's Sunday. Woo! Come on, come on, come on. Are you there? It's Sunday. Yeah, I'm here. Are you there? Come on. Woo! Somebody say amen. Uh-oh, uh-oh. What up? What up, sister? Uh-oh, Sister Dyer's in the building. Come on now. What's up? How you doing, sissy? Come on. Whew. All right, I know we still on it. So let me move on. Come on. You know. Hey, y'all, some of y'all might remember this. Hey, God is in the hood. The G-O-D is in the hood. God is in the hood. The G-O-D is in the hood. God is in the hood. The G-O-D is in the hood. God is in the hood. The G-O-D is in the hood. Yeah, tell your family, tell your neighbor, tell your friend and your teenager. Woo! God is in the building. I can feel him. God is in the building. Yo, can't you feel it? Woo! You so very much, no doubt about it. Tiffany Adams, I want to thank y'all. Woo! Oh my goodness, in Columbia, South Carolina,
It's been some kind of ride and some kind of journey. What's up, Pamela? My family's in the building. Look out, y'all. Come on. I love you. I love you with everything that is within me. Once again, woo, come on. I said, ain't nobody. No, I said, ain't nobody. Woo, I said, ain't nobody like a Holy Ghost party, because a Holy Ghost party don't stop. It don't stop. It don't stop, y'all. Woo, come on. Get your hands up, get your hands up, I'll get your hands up, I'll get your hands up. I'm Lady Jam, and the Jam stands for Jesus anointed me, baby. Lady Jam 2020. Woo! We're gonna put to rest all the fear. We're gonna put to rest all of the hearts that are nervous, because you have a God that is not gonna let you go. You have a God that is gonna be there for you. You have a God that woke you up this morning. You have a God that is gonna hold on to you. You have a God that is gonna let you know that I don't care what the circumstance, woo, you're gonna win. Cause victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Woo, victory is mine. And yo, victory is ours today in Christ, in God, in the God of your understanding. You've got the victory. I know Muslims. I know people who are Baptists. I know people who are Methodists. I know people who are Presbyterians. Come on. Woo. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I feel the Holy Ghost right now. Come on. Woo. Woo. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. I got you. You know what? The soul of America is something that God has to work on. And on that note, we're going to pray that this president tunes in and gets some of this, because he's on a journey, and I realize he's never been told no in the way that he's been told no in this presidency. I realize that because of the money and because of the power, he's never had to get on his knees. But I want you to know today, I know a God that'll show up and knock on the White House door and say, yo, what's up? But that person has to be willing to say, God, I can't do this without you today. So we're going to send up prayers for our president, because he has access to too many of our lives. Amen. Come on. Come on in. There's more people coming in the door. The doors of the church are still open, y'all, because the real church is inside of you and me. Good God Almighty, I'm going crazy in Christ Jesus right now. I said the true church, the real church, is inside of you and me. And depending on how we love, Jesus said they will know that you are my people by the love that you show one to another. Amen. Woo! Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Jesus, my God. Whew. Oh, and see, this is where I gotta wipe the sweat from my brow. You feel me? I'll tell you. Hold on. Just hold on for me. There's some things we gotta cover. Whew. Thank you, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, you are so great. You are so great. You are so great. I love you, God. You are so great. You are so, so great. Oh, it's on and on. No doubt about it. Hold on. Just got to catch my breath a little bit. I'm not as young as I used to be. Not as young as I used to be. But you know, I'm hearing a song by Harold Melvin in the Blue Notes that says, wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed.
said, no more backward thinking, time for thinking ahead. Said, wake up all you preachers, said, preach a new way. And maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say.
Woo!
Wake up everybody, come on, wake up, I said. Sleeping in bed. Ooh, no more. It's time for thinking ahead. And that's how we're gonna get through this COVID-19. We gotta think ahead. We gotta think beyond this circumstance. Batteries in the building. Oh my God. Woo! Ohio, what's up, y'all? Woo! We got people checking in from all over the planet. Jesus, my God. New York's in the building, of course. How y'all doing? What? Reverend Rwanda Gross, you know what it is. I love you. Come on. See, y'all gonna hold on to me, because I'm trying to get to the original message while we're here. But the Holy Spirit is rocking me. Woo! And when it happens, there's no stopping me. Woo! The Holy Spirit is rocking me. Woo! And when it happens, there's no stopping me. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. For all of those beat makers and beat creators that blessed us and that are blessing us right now with the music. I love y'all. And thank you for everything that you're doing. And I want to share something with you. Fear has two meanings. Are y'all ready to go here? Are you ready to go? I said fear has two meanings. And I'm going to work this out real quick, okay? Fear has two meanings. And when you received this Facebook, let me go to it now. You received a post that said, hold on 1 second. I love you guys for your patience. Like I said, this is my first time on here, so trying to get up to speed with everything is taking a little bit more time than I anticipated, but hold on. I got you. Hold on. We get ready. This is gonna be like fire, okay? This is gonna be fire. It's gonna be fire for real. I love you too. I love you too. I sure do. I love you too. Whew. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so now it wants to update my document while I'm live on Facebook, right? Anyway, this is what I was afraid of. Hold on. Hold on, everybody. Oh, I got it. I got it. It's a beautiful thing when God is in the mix. It's a beautiful thing when God can fix it.
God fixed it. We're back in the mix now. This is why I brought you all together, so that we could discuss. Fear has two meanings. And that meaning that I was trying to pull up, fear, everything, number one, fear everything, and run is the first meaning. How many of you are going to run in this situation? Well, first of all, we got to stay at home, so won't be no running anywhere. Well, yeah, you can run, you can walk, but you know what I'm saying, okay? Look, have no fear. This is the first meaning that God gave me here. Fear everything and run. I'm from the streets of New York City, and I ain't running from nobody or nothing. Can you feel me out there? Huh. Whew. Yeah. But this is the choice. And you know what else? What's up, Jeremiah? Jeremiah 1:9, you in the building. That's what's up. You know, we can run, we can hide,
we can doubt, or we can say, ah, you bugging out. But let me tell you something. In the end, if we get up, if we have faith, we hold fast, and we don't run, we win. No matter what the outcome is, we win. When I buried my father, I knew I had to continue on my journey in my trucking career. Because I showed my father before he passed away. I showed my daddy my CDL Class A. And my daddy looked me straight in the eye and said, baby, I wish you all the luck in the world. And at that point, I knew he felt safe that no matter what, I would have an income. Because he knew that I was doing my ministry and it didn't necessarily give me a salary. You feel me? And that may have given him more peace to leave, you know, to know that his baby girl was gonna be all right. Amen. God is something else. I've been spending a lot of time with God since we've been in this house. I'm telling you, in our homes and in our houses. And I challenge you to do the same thing. Number one, fear. The meaning of fear. Fear everything and run. We ain't doing that. Fear. Meaning number two, face everything and rise. Face everything and rise. I don't know about you, but that's what I'm planning to do. I'm planning to face whatever is ahead. I'm planning to face it and move on from here. Whatever the cards that are dealt, whatever I have to accept that I cannot change, I'm willing to face it. Face everything and rise, 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 rise. Come on. I know some of you may have your head hanging down, but let me tell you something, there's a God that will be around to lift you up, lift you up, lift you up, yeah. Said lift you up, lift you up, lift you up, yeah. Ooh. Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. Hi, Margaret, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. God's got it. Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. God's got it. GG! Don't worry. Don't worry, God's got it. 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 Anything that may come our way, because no weapon formed against us shall prosper anyway. Yeah. Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. Jesus, God said, I will give you rest. And no matter what situation, no matter what situation I've had in my life, God hasn't failed me yet. So I want you to get a hold of that thing called fear. I want you to get a hold of that thing called doubt. I want you to get a hold of that thing called worry. And I want you to throw it out. Come on, throw it out. I said, throw it out. Yes, throw it out. Yes, throw it out. Press delete. Yes, press delete. Yes, press delete. Yes, press delete. Press delete on all the negativity. Press delete and come on and get on your feet. Press delete on all the negativity. Press delete and get on your feet. God's got you and God's got it. Thank you. Lord, help me, Jesus. I can't keep y'all all night. But I want to share something else with you that was said by our wonderful governor, Governor Andrew Cuomo here.
here in New York State. Today, that's right, today, he was on the job today, you know? And I don't know, when I seen Governor Cuomo on his job today, on Sunday, I was like, this dude is real. This dude can feel the impact of what's going on and the hearts and minds that are going through so much trauma, not just in New York State, but around the country and around the world. And he said something that I want to share with you. He shared that a statement like this: courage is not the absence of fear. Let me say that again. Courage is not the absence of fear, but rather the assessment that something else is more important than fear. And this was said by Franklin D. Roosevelt. Wow. Courage is not the absence of fear, but rather the assessment that something else is more important than fear. Come on. And I'm gonna put this down, because I don't need it no more. Courage is what we need in this hour. Courage. And let me tell you one more thing. Crisis, any crisis, reveals true character. And on that note, I want to send up prayers to anybody that may be locked in a home with people that are not peaceful, that are violent. People that are not godly but disrespectful. People. Oh God. See, everybody's not at home and happy with the people that they're in the house with, because these people might be doing them harm. So I want to pray right now that God would send a legion of angels into the mix, into the mix, and help them to either exit for their life, help them either ask for help or send out a sign, help them, or help the person who needs God, like I did before God hooked me up with the holy hookup, that person will be changed. That something will be changed in that person. Prayer changes things, y'all. And you can call it old school all you want, but prayer changes things. And last of all, this is the holy hookup. Tell your family, tell your neighbor, tell your friends and your teenager. Pray for everybody. Don't just pray for the people that you love. Don't even just pray for the people that like you. Pray for the people that don't like you. Because if we just love and like the people that love and like us, we ain't doing no more than the other people. Okay? But we will show that we really have a heart. We will show that we really are about agape, unconditional love. If we love somebody, even though they may not love us. And that's what I've done ever since God hooked me up with the holy hookup, because I wasn't welcomed all the time in the church, you know. Let me tell you why. Sometimes it's been because I was black. Sometimes it's been because I'm a lesbian. Sometimes it's been because I was a Christian. Sometimes it's been just because I was a woman. Y'all feel me? And I've handled all of that. Me and God, that's what I'm talking about. We're about to get out of here. I'm not going to keep you any longer than that. But I think what we're going to do is set up some Zoom meetings so that I can get you talking back to me. I think that'll be nice. So during the week, we're going to do that. But every Sunday, you can catch the holy hookup right here. I'll send out a Facebook Live post and let you know when everything is gonna go down so we can go up, all right? But I'm Reverend LaDonna Clark, AKA Lady Jam. And the Jam stands for Jesus. Nefertiti. I love you. And the Jam stands for Jesus. Anointed me. I'm not playing with God. I just know that I'm just a nobody. I'm just a nobody. Nobody trying to tell everybody. Trying to tell everybody. Oh, about somebody. 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 Woo! That can change a life. I know God can change a life. I know God, this can change a life. I know it for myself. Yeah, I know it, and I know it for myself. Can't nobody take it from me, no. Can't nobody take it from me, y'all. Cause what I got, the world didn't give it to me. I said, what I got, woo, the world didn't give it to me. They can't take it away. Take it away, nobody can take it away. Take it away, nobody can take it away. Take it away, nobody can take it away. Take it away. This is the Holy Hookah. And of course, it's the Church in the Hood Faith and Hip Hop Movement. Tell your family, tell your neighbor, tell your friend and your teenager. Wash your hands, stay safe, and please keep your behind home. Young people and everybody, because the sooner we all stay home and let the hospitals get better prepared for this epidemic, we need the hospitals to get prepared. So we need to stay home and not overload them with our sicknesses, and understand that you may not have a bad time with COVID-19, but you may give it to somebody else that may die, you feel me? So that's what it's about. Stay home, be careful, be safe, keep your spirits up, and know that I love you with all my heart and soul, and we're gonna get through this, okay? I promise you, we're gonna get through this. Just love on yourselves, love on each other. Hey, have you talked to your family lately? Call your family and let them know that you love them. Call them and FaceTime them, or call them and get on a video chat. This is the time to play catch up on those things that we haven't been doing, those things that we've been putting off, those things that because of our careers we've kind of let fall to the wayside. To my family that's listening, I love you. And I know I haven't always been there for you, because when you're an entertainer, it takes you on the road. And when you're also in the ministry, it takes you on the road. And when I was on the road, you know, opening up for Bobby Brown's Prerogative Tour, Tony Terry from Epic Records, when I was on the road and I was bringing on stage Run DMC and Salt and Pepper, Heavy D and the Boys, and the Fat Boys, when I was on the road and on the same stage with Rick James when he said Fire It Up in Columbia, South Carolina, when I was on the road, it really took a lot of time from my family. It really took a lot of time from loved ones. God bless you, Brother Thomas. I love you guys. Take time and know that this moment is very important. What we do with this moment is very important. I gotta get out of here, because I just gotta get out of here, because I know people gotta go. But I feel overwhelmed in your love and in the spirit of the Most High God. Love everybody, no matter what country they come from, no matter who they are. Oh, what's up, B? How you doing? Oh, how you doing? God bless you. Chicago's in the building, y'all. My goodness. Hey, Ruth. Yvonne, I love y'all. My goodness, y'all just really blessed my soul and my spirit today. Thank you. I can feel your love. Whew. The Holy Hookup, brought to you by Church in the Hood, the faith and hip-hop movement. We're going to take this thing all across the nation. I want to give a shout-out to my good friend in Atlanta, Brother Miko Evans. I love you, man. Give a shout-out to Tassie. Love you, too, in Atlanta. And also want to give a shout-out to my trucker buddy. You know who you are, Dolores. I love y'all. I love all of y'all. Thank you. God bless you. This is the Holy Hookup, and we will do it again. I gotta go. I gotta go. God bless you. Remember, not by power, Zechariah 4:6. Not by power, Zechariah 4:6. Not by power nor by might, but by God's Spirit. Thus saith the Lord. By God's Spirit. Thus saith the Lord. Amen.